Hello everybody, this video I am preparing particularly for all those students who wants to go for this IELTS exam. So I will start the conversation with one of my students here at my institute, and we are going to discuss about particular category of the question, that is double question type of category. Okay, and hope so through the conversation you are going to get the maximum benefit. Okay. So without having any further delay, let's start the conversation. Okay. So as we have done, okay, all the things and the rudimentary skills about like writing task, this one particularly double question, if it is there, how we need to handle and whatever different questions that I'm going to ask you, you need to just reply accordingly. Whatever you feel right and wrong, whatever you feel it, okay, there's nothing like prepared. Okay, we are just giving the natural replies. Okay, you have to give your natural reply. Okay, so as far as whatever you have gone through, can you please explain what is the process?
Yes, sir. Firstly, in introduction,
yeah,
we should write general statement.
Mm-hmm.
Then the answer the question first, which is asked.
Mm-hmm.
Then in brief.
Mm-hmm.
Then answer the question second.
Mm-hmm.
In brief.
Okay.
Then in body paragraph one.
Mm-hmm.
Explain the first answer of first question.
Yes.
Firstly, we write the general statement for the first question.
Mm-hmm.
Then we give a reason.
Mm-hmm.
Why it is true.
Now that explanation we'll talk at length, in detail we'll talk. Firstly, we'll talk about that only, like what we have gone through as a basic skeleton.
Yes.
Okay.
Then body paragraph one.
Mm-hmm.
Answer the first question in explain.
With explanation. Yeah, exactly.
Then body paragraph two.
Mm-hmm.
Explain the second answer.
Mm-hmm.
Then conclusion.
Okay.
General statement and explain.
Yeah, the way that those are to be discussed.
Yes.
In detail. Now let's talk about the general statement. Suppose you are writing the introduction.
Yes.
What we have done about general statement, how we need to write general statement, from where we are going to get it. Like suppose there is a statement I am giving you right now, there is a statement. You need not to reply for that, but just simply you need to let me know about it, that how we need to find it out, that this way I can get my general statement. Like the statement is, Fossil fuels are essentially important for producing electricity, or we can say fossil fuels are essential for producing electricity, powering industry and fueling transportation. However, one day we will reach to a point when all the world's fossil fuels have been depleted, gone. Okay. How can we conserve these resources? And what are some alternatives to fossil fuels? Okay, the main thing. Okay, so the two questions which are given after that, how can we conserve these resources and what are some alternatives to the fossil fuels?
Yes.
I believe these are the two questions which are to be answered. Double question, no? Then when it comes to like the first given information, whether is it going to give you the stimulus or whatever material for the general statement? Yes, it is going to give you the material for writing the
general
statement. What exactly the general statement is? It's like your point of view. Like what is general statement?
General statement is a statement
which is
explain the.
Explain the statement in
paraphrasal language.
Yeah, paraphrasal language. Exactly, in the paraphrasal way we try to write it in our own words. Like using some of the words one or the other way, same, but in different form. Like whatever statement is given over there, we are not going to use the same sort of words. Okay, same categories cannot be used, but we need to change. Like same word can be used, but in different form. You can use it. But the thing is, in case you are not using it, what else can we use? Synonyms. We can use synonyms to alter that whole of the thing and paraphrase it. Paraphrase means, what do I mean by that? What did I understand by that? If your understanding is right for that given statement, no? most of the chances are that you are going to write your right answer. There won't be any wrong notions in your mind about the concept of whatever you're going to write. Okay, then the other two questions are to be answered also.
Yes.
Clear? If we take example of how can we conserve these resources, okay, how to save the resources, and other is like what are some alternatives to the fossil fuels. Okay, that is the second question. As far as I said that general statement is to be written like that one, in the second statement, what we're gonna write?
In the second statement, we can write for answer of the first question.
In brief means to say you're going to tell the main idea of the same, and then thereafter in the second statement you're gonna write
the
main idea of the second answer that you're going to write. Okay.
Yes.
And what will be your body paragraphs?
In first body paragraph,
mm-hmm.
we explain the first answer,
mm-hmm.
Firstly we write first general statement.
Mm-hmm. No, then, not general statement. It can't be general statement. It will be main point.
Main point
that I feel why or what, whatever question is asked. Accordingly that your main point, primary point, exact primary point you're going to tell, most crucial thing that you're going to write. Okay.
Yes.
And as you're going to give your point, what else is to be done after that? You have to give
reason
for your answer, and then example for it, and then culminate that one at the end, like restate your view, main idea. Got it? So same thing you're going to follow in the second paragraph also. Like in second paragraph, you're going to give the reply for the
second answer.
Clear? Got it? You're going to have the main idea for the same, you're going to have the answer for the same, and then you're going to write the in simple words, and then thereafter you're going to write it in what we say, example with example. You can give your personal examples also. Okay. We'll come to the points. We are going to knit it together. Okay. We'll talk about different other basic skills which are required for it. Okay. First thing is like, the most important aspect of checking, like when the examiner is going to check you, first thing which is very important is your variety of statements. Obviously, there is no other way to let other person know that like how much of the grammar I know, how many skills I have as far as you know, my grammar structures are concerned. Okay. What are the different constructions that we have to do and we should do as far as these tasks are concerned, task number one and two?
First is task achievement.
Mm-hmm. No, these are actually the basic fundamentals by which we examine.
Yes.
Okay, I'm saying that what are the different statements that we need to write? What category of the statements? I think we have done that. I told you.
Complex
sentences. Yes.
Compound statements.
Yes.
Complex compound statements.
Complex compound. Simple statements can also be written, but how to lengthen up the statement? Let's talk about that, because that's very important question for the viewers.
We should use connectors,
mm-hmm.
conjunctions, as well as prepositions.
Prepositions.
Yes.
Prepositions to lengthen up the statement so that it will become a little bit of like more academic statement. Okay, it should not be of four words or five words or six words. If it is of that category also, the word usage should be good one. Okay, but it is not like that. We can't write. Obviously, when we say that, when we plan, actually it comes into play, the whole skeleton comes into play. What I'm going to write in my journal statement, what am I going to write in my body paragraph 1 and 2 and all that, and in introduction, whatever are the different subcategories of the points, those are very important to be seen. Okay, and then thereafter coming to the conclusion, when we come to the conclusion, okay, I'm coming to the conclusion very fast, okay, but we'll talk about other things in the body paragraphs now. Okay. When we talk about body paragraphs, particularly body paragraphs, in that one, as we write the first main point, okay, Thereafter, what is to be done?
Give reason.
Reason for it. And how can we elaborate that point? By using which conjunctions?
By using adversative conjunctions.
Adversative, opposite view. If we want to lengthen up the statement, what else we need to do is, like suppose we want to add further information to that, we use additive connectors. Additive connect, moreover, furthermore, and all that. So those are used to add information. But as far as if I want to say that in simple words, the same statement, whatever we say, we can say it in simple words. Clear? Same information, like as a primary point, but in simple words, so that the other person, whomever the examiner is, will be able to assess that the person's point is clear to the person, whomever is writing. Clear? And then after that one, what else? Like as that point is written, okay, then the next thing that you have to give is example. Example doesn't mean that you have to write for example, for instance, it's not like that. You can write example naturally. If it is coming naturally, it's fine. Okay. But if it is coming unnatural way, after every point you are trying to give example, it's not right. It's not at all expected from any of the learner. Okay. Now, when we give example, we can use for example, like all these constructions, but not all the times. Okay. There are different ways to give example, like such as, we use such as, like when we give the point and we say such as, that is also the one of the way to give examples. Okay, if ways to give the example, like in case you're trying to write always the same sort of constructions in your body paragraph 1 and 2, so definitely it would be monotonous. Your idea representation would be monotonous. It should not be like the same. Okay. And then when you give example, you can give your personal examples also. If it is mentioned over there, you can give your personal examples. When you are mentioning your personal examples also, the most important aspect that comes into play is usage of action verbs. Okay. Usage of action verbs. And as far as the variety of sentences are concerned, I'll tell you what are the different sentences later on. Firstly, we'll talk about the next thing. Like when we have given example, we can use the survey and all that. In that survey, I have done that, or like whatever it is. Okay. Like I have read this point in that magazine or something. As far as the survey done by this magazine is concerned, like they did this or that research. Researchers found that. Okay. Experts found that. Like when you give example. So that's very important. Okay. Then to give example particularly. And then thereafter, when you culminate the points, what we do? We use the elative conjunctions. What are those? Does, hence, yeah. Okay. So what has happened? You can write that in the clause form, making the use of complex statements. Most of the time, the students who get the better bands, they write complex statements. Okay. Complex statements where the clauses are being used, subordinate clauses are being used to lengthen up the statement or make it little bit complex to understand. I would say that easy to understand, but complex to be written. Okay. Students do not understand the logic behind it, but I believe like with the practice only you can do it. So as far as different things which are to be done there, with different statements are to be written there, let me just elaborate that one. First of all, you need to be taking care of the action verbs. Write more statements which carry action verbs rather than using helping verb in your writing. Second, you need to be careful about your modal verbs. Okay, modal verbs can be used. Don't use is, am, are, was, were, has, have, had, do, did, does, or and all that. Has, have, had depends upon kind of statement that you write. But you can write modal verbs most of the time. They are very, very helpful, essentially helpful sort of like category of the auxiliary verb, like must. What are those? Can, could, may, might, must, need, dare, ought, to, and all that. Okay, all such categories of the modal verbs are very important. And as you use them, they are used according to the necessity, the requirement. It's not like everywhere we can apply can, everywhere we can apply may. depends upon the possibility. If the weak possibility is there, might can be used. If the stronger, little bit stronger possibility, may can be used. And if better than that is there, then different other modal verbs are there which can be used. Should can be used for the suggestion. Okay, like the combination with should have, would have, could have, plus third form. If these sort of like the past participle sort of combinations are possible, and the students are able to write, you are able to write, you'll get good bands. Okay, like conjunctions, very important thing, like to bind that all the paragraphs together, all the statements together. Those are important for what? Like for your the second point to be remembered, that is coherence and cohesion. Okay, so very important, like binding the statements together is very important, that thing. And after that one, we have our lexical resource, the vocabulary. I told you that variety of word, one word has different forms. You can write different forms, they won't be considered as one word. Okay, if you are writing the same word again and again, repetition is done, it will be like giving you negative marking for that. Like definitely your bands are going to decrease by that. And then thereafter, like what else is there? Like collocations are very important. Like we are doing the collocations in another video, we are going to upload that one also. Like half of them are done, not half of them, it's just a start. We're going to talk more on the collocations. Okay, let's see that one, what else we can do about it. And then thereafter, as far as like other statements are concerned, like combinations, like not only but also, that combination. Then although, though, okay, hardly with when, scarcely with when, and no sooner with than, than, than. Okay, so such sort of combinations or conditional statements, we have done three conditionals. Okay, in like if we are using those three conditionals in our statements, then definitely our ideas would be pumped up. Okay, so they will be enlightened. Okay, properly enlightened. And as far as conclusion is concerned, we can use connector in the beginning and then we can conclude it accordingly. We need to restate the general statement in that and then give the answer for the restate that answer for the first one, restate the answer for the second one, but restate in different paraphrasal language. Don't say the same sort of tone or same sort of statement as we have written in the beginning. Obviously there is some change that we have made by explaining our answer, by explaining the answer at length. Okay, in body paragraph 1 and 2. Clear? And then thereafter, that's it, that's your essay all done. Okay, and at the end of your essay, what you need to check, you need to go for subject verb agreement topic. Okay, when you have written down your essay, suppose you have completed your essay in 35 minutes or what we say, like exactly 30 minutes, 32 minutes, 35 minutes. Most of the time you should take 35 minutes so that you have time to reread it and check out that combinations. Okay, subject verb combination thoroughly, go by that. And then thereafter, what we do, like we check whether I have used the synonyms correctly or not, my word spellings are right or not. Everything you have to assess thoroughly. Clear? And after rereading it, you see that one, cutting is not to be done. It's not like there is any sort of like marks decrease or something, it's not like that. But still, we need to, if we are going to present ideas cleanly, okay, cleanliness matters the most. Okay, so if you are going to present your ideas, presentation is very, very beautiful, then definitely maximumly the person is going to, you know, see through the grammar mistakes. And if you have already gone through the grammar properly, your mistakes are going to be quite less. Okay, so chances are that one, you are at least you are going to get 6.5 on the go, like in case you have basically written the whole structure like that. Okay, it's not even you have elaborated all the points, it's not like that. But even if you have written simple language, it doesn't matter. Okay, then what else? Like the first thing about writing an essay is not like simply dividing them into the different statements, it's planning. Firstly, you plan, obviously we plan, then we execute. Okay, planning is very important. In planning, what we do? These statements, basic statements are to be written. Yeah. And what else?
Firstly, we write up our basic statement.
Mm-hmm.
Then our
basic pattern, that means.
Yes, sir. In basic pattern, in introduction, what we write?
Mm-hmm.
We write in brief.
Mm-hmm. Brief. Spider, yeah.
Like a spider.
Mm-hmm. Not spider diagram. I won't say that spider. Yeah, we can write spider. In a different way, yeah, we can write in a flowchart form. We can write it small points.
Yes.
We can write small points. We can't elaborate everything, no. So generating the idea will come only when you're gonna plan. But if you are not going to generate it, generate the ideas, you are going to write something new in your body paragraphs. And in conclusion also, you're gonna write something new, which is not acceptable. Conclusion means conclusion. You came to the conclusion, that's it. Okay. So this is it. I believe that the students like who are listening to me are going to get the benefit of the same as you are getting. And I believe that one, after this one, like I would recommend you to keep on watching the videos on English Lovers by Hannity and keep learning. Stay safe. Okay. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.